Hi guys, Greg here. Welcome back to my channel. This is my second video from the Setting Out series, and in today's video I'm going to show you the EDM Leica TS06. So the Leica comes in the box like this. It's a plastic box. I think it weighs 7 kg. Just when you're gonna be open the box, remember you don't have it upside down, and you're gonna see TS06 here and the Leica logo on top. You got the two clamps here. You just lift them like this and open like that, and then you can open your box. So in the box you're gonna find EDM itself, of course. You're gonna find the battery charger in two pieces. You're gonna find the prism and the prism poles. We got the rain cover here, and it's not actually rain cover in the cover. This is shade for your EDM. You're gonna install this like that when it's too much sun, and you got the problem with the sun shining directly into your EDM. We got the tape, Leica tape here, which are never really used. And the most important thing is calibration certificate. So this you're gonna be always looking for when first opening the boxes. You're gonna be asked for it, and you need to make sure it's not out of date. And here you can find the information about the last calibration date, which is 3rd of September 19, which means the next one is due a year later, so 2020, 3rd of September. Okay, so I'm gonna take the EDM out of the box now and tell you a few things about it. And this I'm going to be repeating maybe even every video. This is a very sensitive equipment, and very expensive as well, and especially robotic type, which I'm going to show you later. So just make sure you always take extra care when using these instruments. So you take it out. I leave the box open for now, as I'm going to show you the prism in a minute. So I show you first how to take the battery off. You just turn this thing here left, and it doesn't pop out this time. You have to just sometimes tap it like that. So there you go, there's your battery here. Just take it out like this. It's very simple. You got the plus sign and minus, so you cannot go wrong really. And just take it in. I'm going to show you later how to charge it. It's very simple as well. So you just press it back in, push it in, turn the black thingy right, and there you go. On the right hand side of the EDM, it tells you the Bluetooth and the USB connection, and that's how you're going to be transferring data in and out of the instrument after doing some surveys, or just into the EDM. You can actually see here the USB is in, and you got a connection here to your computer. So let's put the USB back, and I'm gonna just push it back in, turn right, and it's in. Okay, so you can see you got the screen, and we got the keyboard here. All this I'm gonna show you in the next video, when I'm gonna go through the settings. We're gonna open new job, and we're gonna type in some coordinates for the job we're gonna be using later in the programs. So this I'm gonna leave for later, but the next thing I'm gonna show you is to level in the instrument. You see the bubble here, and we're going to be leveling the instrument like this using the tri-brack. But I just show you something here. I will take the EDM off the tri-brack really to show you better how to level the instrument, and that's actually The next thing you need to know, you just take it using this, turn it like that. You can lift your EDM off the tri-brack. I'm gonna put it back into the box so it's safe. And the best way really, and the easiest way to level your instrument or to level your tri-brack is when you got these two thumb screws, you're gonna be using like that in and out. This is gonna be changing the level on this axis, and that one thumb screw gonna be changing on this one. So let's have a look. You're gonna see the bubble when I'm turning these two. It's going right and left. So at this point, I know I need to turn this one to get it level. So I'm coming in, and there we go. If I'm gonna go more, it goes there. If I'm gonna go this way, it goes this way. So that one bolt in this set goes this way, and them two working on this axis here. So I'm gonna put the EDM back on the tri-brack, and the thing is, sometimes you're gonna be using only this separately, as not, you're not always gonna be using the tripod. Sometimes you're gonna be using the monopod. It depends on the situation you're gonna be setting out. So you need to know this. So I'm gonna put it back on the tri-brack. And I turned just fixed tri-brack into the EDM. And I'm gonna turn it on now just to show you that the first screen, you're gonna be screen showing you the level of the instrument. And you're gonna find that your instrument is actually set to show you what thumb screw you should use. So you can see now the EDM tells me actually I should use these two thumb screws this way. Now they out. And it gonna show me now this way. And you can see that's what I just said before. Them to work going this way. So now it asked me to move this one down. Okay. So it's something like this. Obviously the EDM is not on the tripod, and this is only to show you how it works. So next thing I'm going to show you, it's the EDM here and how we're going to be measuring at the targets. And this really works like a monocular, I'd say, when you're going to be watching through this, turning, there is a small infinity sign here. So you go left to see further and further, and you zoom in this way. This one closer here, you turn as well just to get your crosshair focused, so we're gonna see clearly what you're aiming at. But the first thing, when we're gonna be aiming at the target, we're gonna be using the cross here, which I hope you're gonna see two lines in a minute. You can see that cross now. So this is actually how we're gonna be looking for the targets and aiming. So first we look through this, you turn your EDM, so you're looking, you find it. You find the cross, that's the position I'm aiming, perfect. And then you're gonna jump here, you're gonna get your focus so you clearly see the target. Then you turn the smaller one just to get your crosshair really visible, and that's it really. To sum up that looking for target, you just turn your EDM like this and this, and when you come closer, you turn in this to move it left and right, just small bit, and here this sign, this is gonna go in up and down. You probably cannot see it right now, as this is really small movement just to get your target in the perfect aim. So I think that's all you need to know about the EDM really from the outside. You got the antenna here, but you don't really use it. It's like a handle here, and it's a bit different when I'm gonna be showing you the robotic EDM, and this is actually the radio handle, and you can detach and attach it. So the last thing I'm going to show you, it's the prism, as this is the one you're going to be using. So the prism itself, as you can see, got the constant here. When you use the targets, you have to just be careful. You need to make sure you change the settings in the EDM for the proper target. So how to set your prism? You got prism poles. Each prison pole is 300 long, you got 100, 200, 300, so you can use this as well. When you check some levels, you can actually put the height you're using to get the real height of the target or of your survey point. So you're gonna attach this to the pole. Now you can attach the prism here. And the distance from the bottom of the pogo to the center of the prism, it's 50 mil as well. So this is 50 mil, this is 50 mil, and this is 300. So now distance here is 400. So I'm gonna attach on the top of the prism one more pole, and that's the way you're gonna be holding it. So you can see there is a bubble as well, and then just to make sure your chainman or your assistant gonna be holding it right, that's the way you're gonna find it, and then you're gonna be shooting it. So that's it really. TSO6 comes with charger like this. This is plugged in now, and to charge the battery it's very easy. You can see here plus minus, you just push it in, press it in like this, and it starts charging. So you can see now this battery is almost full, and we're gonna take it down. There's two types of batteries coming with the EDM, but TSO6 usually comes with two small batteries, so you really need to make sure you got always one full battery handy, and or you can always get yourself the big battery as I did myself. Guys, that's it in today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and I believe you just make another step forward in your setting out site engineering knowledge. If you have any questions, if something was unclear, please let me know, leave in the comment below. And please guys, subscribe to my channel and turn the notifications on so you're gonna know when my next video gonna be released. So thank you again for watching, and see you next time back on my channel.